Hello everyone, welcome back to The Happenstance Chef. This week, we're making blueberry cake. But instead of using processed sugar, we're substituting honey, and it works. Before we get started today, like, hit the bell if you want to be notified of the next episode, and I would love it if you subscribed. I promise you great content every time. I wanted to make a blueberry cake without sugar. I'm sort of looking at my diet, and I'm looking at the processed sugar, and I thought, okay, I've been making oatmeal for myself every day, and I've been using honey instead of sugar, and I thought, what if I could substitute the same amount of honey for sugar? So that's what I decided to do. Now, I have to be honest, I didn't want to make this and have it not work for you. So I tried it once, and there's a couple things I learned. One is, here is a cup of flour, eighth a teaspoon of salt, and a half a teaspoon of baking soda. I think the ingredients are below. But I didn't get as much rise or lift as I wanted. And so I figured sifting flour usually helps doing that. So two things I'm going to do right now. I have a stick of butter in here, and I'm going to whip that really hard, because usually you're creaming butter and sugar. But we're not going to be creaming butter and sugar. We're going to be creaming butter and honey. So I give this a chance to go up to a nice speed, and I'm gonna sift the flour, which is gonna go in later. So I'm gonna add the blueberries at the end, after the batter is in there, and I'm just gonna press them down. But, so they don't sink to the bottom, I'm gonna do two things. I'm gonna add a bit of lemon juice. I'm squeezing it in my hand, even though it may burn, because I wanna catch the seeds. So that's about a teaspoon of lemon juice in there. And then some flour. And then I'm just gonna mix these up so they're coated with flour and the lemon juice. And now, time to get the honey in. Let's see. First, what I'm gonna do, just turn this down for a minute so that I can actually scrape the butter down on the sides before I add the honey. All right, now I'm gonna get the honey in there. And because when you're creaming butter and sugar, you cream it till it gets light and fluffy, I can't use the same measure here of how well it's doing. All right, that is starting to look pretty creamy and fluffy. I'm gonna scrape it down again. I love blueberries. Growing up in Philadelphia in South Jersey, plenty of fresh blueberries in the summer. Fresh blueberry, tomatoes, and white sweet corn. All right, now, we're gonna slow the mixer down to low speed and hoping that I get no eggshells in the mix. I'm gonna add two large eggs, one at a time, till it's mixed. Let's turn that up just a little bit more.
Well, Martha Stewart says that you should crack the egg on a flat surface, not on the edge like you're doing.
Okay, well, when Martha Stewart is cooking with me, I'll do it her way.
We'll make it happen.
Now, if Snoop Dogg is cooking with me, I wonder how he cracks an egg.
I'm sure the proper way. Because he's taught by Martha Stewart. They used to have a show, didn't they?
I think they still do. Now, I'm going to keep it at this low speed, and I'm going to add this sifted flour in just slowly. So that's the flour, baking soda, a little bit of salt. I'm using unsalted butter, by the way. But if you use salted butter, you can leave out the eighth of a teaspoon of salt. And that looks pretty gosh darn good. So you want to keep it till it's just combined. Oh, you know what I forgot?
What?
I forgot the quarter teaspoon of vanilla. Probably is, but let's see. If I add it half at a time, maybe we'll be fine. It needs to go in. Where it needs to go in is right after the honey is combined with the butter, then the vanilla extract goes in. But I think we'll be okay. This already looks a little fluffier than my first go-round at this honey-sweetened blueberry deliciousness. By the way, I know I've said this before. I absolutely love cooking because I can mess with flavors and experiment. With baking, and that's why I did do this ahead of time, with baking, because it's chemistry, and because, let's just say, chemistry was not my best subject in high school. I think Mr. Corcoran was my teacher. He's also my lacrosse coach. Very understanding chemistry teacher. All right, so just spreading the dough evenly. We're going to be putting this in a preheated 350 oven at, well, for 45 minutes. Okay, so you can see I pressed the blueberries down in there, and I'm ready to put it in the oven, and we'll be back in 45 minutes. It's actually cooked a lot faster than I thought, and so this cooked at 35 minutes. So what I would do if I were you is check it at 30 minutes with a tester or a cake tester or a toothpick, and if it comes out clean, it's done. When you let it cool for 10 to 15 minutes on the rack. Right now I'm just getting it away from the sides. I'm going to undo the spring form. Oh yes, that's beautiful. Oh, look at that. That's really beautiful. I probably could have spread the blueberries out a little more, but it does look really nice. So I'm going to cut into it here. Look at that. Look at that. I used to live and work in London, and on a Saturday, there's a big proper place for cake. And these are actually based, and I tried to do touristy things every weekend that I was there, or go to another country since I was there, just to see my way around. So back in 1999, I toured Buckingham Palace, and in the gift shop were these plates that are actually based on the white damask walls in the drawing room. So isn't that fun? Okay, Andrew, I'm now cutting my slice.
These are some huge slices.
All right, as always, Andrew, yeah. You get to go first.
Take time.
I will say, the last time you said the cake was a little dry, which let me know that I needed to cook it at less time.
It looks very, very moist. So let's try it. Very good.
Describe good.
I don't know if because of the blueberries, but it feels very healthy. It feels very light.
It is very light. It's much fluffier than the other one was. Actually, it looks like you can see the honey. And the honey against the blueberries, really tasty.
Yeah, very good.
So, I think if you're going to experiment, I think from up to a cup of honey replacing sugar, I think you can do that. But if you have 2 cups, I got to figure that one out if I do that. So, there you go. This is now a honey blueberry cake. You can see that Andrew doesn't like it at all. He did say it was a rather large piece, and I'm guessing it'll be gone in a moment. So, thank you for joining me again on The Happenstance Chef. Be sure to like, feel free to comment, hit the bell if you want to know when the next episode is, and please subscribe. I love making content for you. And if you've got a challenge for me, something you want me to cook or bake that isn't going to take me 2 weeks, then please put it in the comments below, and I'll let you know when I'm going to do your challenge. Bye-bye. See you next time.
Delicious.